Okay, so now we are going to solve some problems which are related to homomorphisms. So let us solve the first problem. Suppose phi is a function which is from Sn to Z2, where Z2 is a group with respect to addition modulo 2, and Sn is a group with respect to composition. And I'm going to define a permutation, I'm going to define a map, this map phi, by phi of sigma is equal to, so the sigma is a permutation is Sn. So suppose sigma is even, then I'm going to write the image as 0 bar in Z2. And suppose the permutation sigma is odd, then I'm going to write the image as 1 bar in Z2. So pictorically, this function phi is mapping the set Sn to Z2. Suppose I have a permutation tau, which is even, then the image of tau will be how much? 0 bar. And suppose tau is odd, if it's an odd permutation, then the image will be how much? The image will be 1 bar. So this is how the function phi works. Okay. Now we want to show that this phi is a homomorphism. So I will write show phi is a homomorphism. So how will I solve this? So now we will make different cases. So let me split up into the first case. Suppose sigma and tau are both even. Okay, suppose sigma and tau are both even. In this case, what will happen is phi of sigma, any even permutation will go to what? If it is even, then it will go to 0 bar. So phi of sigma is 0 bar, and what is phi of tau? Phi of tau will also be 0 bar, because even permutations are getting mapped to 0 bar and odd permutations are getting mapped to 1 bar, right? So if sigma is even and tau is even, then what can we say about sigma composite tau? And sigma composite tau is also even, because even permutation, composite even permutation is again a even permutation, because both are elements of An, right? And we know that An is a group. So phi of sigma composite An, sigma composite tau is also how much? That is also equal to zero. Now, therefore, by definition, what can I say? So by definition, I know that phi of x star y is equal to phi of x star dash phi y. This is the definition of the homomorphism. So here, the role of star is played by composition, right? So sigma composite tau, and role of star dash. Star dash is the operation of Z2. The operation of Z2 is addition modulo 2. So is equal to phi of sigma plus phi of tau, right? So this will be how, so what is the left hand side? The left hand side is zero, and the right hand side, phi of sigma is also zero bar, and phi of tau is also how much? Phi of tau is also zero bar. So this addition is again zero bar. So this, for case one, it is actually verified that we are getting zero is equal to zero plus zero. Okay, now if we go to the second case, so we will now let sigma to be even and let tau to be odd permutation. In this case, what will happen? What is phi of sigma? Since sigma is even, it is zero bar, and phi of tau is how much? Phi of tau will be equal to one bar. Okay, and now what is sigma composite tau? So if sigma is even and tau is odd, then the composite will be which type of permutation? Will be again an odd permutation. Why is it odd? Because sigma has even number of transpositions and tau has odd number of transposition. So sigma composite tau will have odd plus even, and odd plus even is again odd. So sigma composite tau will be an odd permutation, and therefore phi of sigma composite tau is nothing but one bar, right? And what is phi of sigma addition modulo 2 phi of tau? So this is equal, what is phi of sigma? It is 0 bar plus 1 bar. So you see that the right hand side, sigma phi of sigma plus phi of tau is also 1 bar, and phi of sigma composite tau is also 1 bar. Therefore, the identity phi of sigma composite tau equal to phi of sigma plus phi of tau. This identity is again verified in the second case also. And now what is the third case? In the third case, we will take both sigma and tau to be what? Both sigma and tau to be odd. In this case, phi of sigma is 1 bar and phi of tau is also 1 bar. And therefore, what about sigma composite tau? Now, if both are odd, then the number of transpositions in sigma composite tau will be even, because it will be odd plus odd. So this is an even permutation, and therefore phi of sigma composite tau will be equal to 0 bar, right? And what about phi of sigma plus phi of tau? Addition modulo is how much? Addition modulo 2, remember. This will be 1 bar plus 1 bar. So 1 bar plus 1 bar is 2 bar, and 2 bar is congruent to 0 bar. So this means that again here phi of sigma composite tau is also 0 bar, and phi of sigma plus phi of tau is also 0 bar. So again the identity is verified. So phi of sigma composite tau is again equal to phi of sigma plus phi of tau. So all the three cases are over. So therefore this means that in all the cases we got this identity, and therefore this proves that phi is what? Phi is a homomorphism from SN to Z2. So for second problem, I will need some basics. So we all know what is C01 defined as. C01 is the set of all continuous functions on the interval 01, on the closed interval 01. Okay, so this set of continuous functions with respect to the operation addition, if I use the operation addition, then this set C01 with plus, what is the addition? It is the component wise addition of the functions. This set forms a group. Okay, so now what we will do is we will take a function phi, which is from this group. The group is C01 with respect to addition, and on the right hand side the codomain I will take real numbers with respect to addition. Okay, so what is the function that I'm going to define? What is phi that I'm going to define? Phi of f. Now what is this f? This f is a member of C01, means f is a continuous function. Okay, and what am I going to write the image as? The image should be a real number. So from a continuous function, I want to produce a real number. And how will I produce a real number? I will integrate that function f, and I will evaluate the between the limits 0 to 1, because f is a function in C01, means f is a continuous function on which interval? F is a continuous function on the interval 0, 1. Okay, this phi is doing what? So it is taking, so let me show the picture. So this is C01 and this is the real line. Okay, here I'm going to take a function. Okay, and I'm going to map that function to its integral value. So for example, if I take the function f is equal to f of x is equal to x square. Suppose I take f of x equal to x square. Now where will this function phi send this f to? So clearly phi of f means phi of x square, because the function f is x square, and I'm going to integrate that function x square dx. This is the integration. I'm using the variable x or t, it is same. So and I'm going to integrate it, and this will be x cubed by 3, and when I evaluate the integration, I will get 1/3. So the function x square will map to which real number? It will map to the real number 1/3. Suppose I take the function to be the zero function, then what is the integration of the zero function? It is 0. So the zero function will map to 0 itself. Okay. Suppose I take the function is, suppose I take x cube, where will the function x cube map to? What is the integration of x cube? The integration of x cube is x raised to 4 upon 4. And when I evaluate the limits from 0 to 1, okay, I'm going to get 1/4. So this x raised to 4 function is going to map to which point? It is going to map to the point 1/4 on the real length. So this is how this function phi works. It takes functions and maps it to what? And it maps to the real numbers, and which real number? The real number which is the integration of that function between the limits 0 to 1. Okay. So our exercise will be that we have to show that this function phi, the function phi is phi of f is equal to integration from 0 to 1 of f dt. This function phi is a homomorphism. Okay. And is it 1-1? We are also going to check that. Is this function a 1-1 function? Okay. So let us write the answer now. So clearly, if I start with the definition, we know that phi of x star y is equal to phi x star dash phi y. This is the definition. Now, here, this x and y are actually representing what? They are elements from the domain, and the domains are functions here. So I want to check that phi of f g, what is the operation for the domain? What is the operation in the domain? It is c01. So f and g are c01 functions, means they are continuous functions, and the operation is addition. So here I have plus is equal to phi of x and phi of y. What is the operation of the codomain? It is real numbers with respect to addition. So this is addition with respect to real number. So both the operations are plus here. The left hand side plus is nothing but addition of functions, and this is nothing but addition of real numbers. Only that is the difference. So when I start with the left hand side, what will I get? What is phi of f plus g? Phi of f plus g is integration from 0 to 1 f of f plus g of t dt. So this is how the definition of phi is. And we know that integration of f plus g t dt is nothing but integration of ft plus gt dt. Okay, so this is equal to how much? This is equal to integration of from 0 to 1 ft dt plus integration of gt dt. This comes from your Riemann integration exercises, and this is nothing but phi of f, and this is phi of g. So this function phi is a homomorphism. Okay, now what we want to check, that is phi a 1-1 homomorphism? Okay, now we know that if we take two different functions, suppose I take the function f equal to x and the other function g, suppose I take half, this is a constant function. Okay, g is a constant function. G of x is equal to how much? G of x is equal to half, and this the first function is f of x equal to x. Now what is image of f? What is phi of f? Phi of f is integration of x from 0 to 1, which is x square by 2, and when I evaluate the limits, I will get half. So if phi of f is half, and what is phi of g? Phi of g is integration of the function half, constant function half, which is 0 to 1, and that is the integration of half is half again. So what we observed here is that f and g are not equal. Okay, but what am I getting? I'm getting that phi of f and phi of g are what? Phi of f and phi of g are equal. So this should not happen if the function is 1-1. By 1-1 function, we mean that if a is not equal to b, then phi of a should not be equal to phi of b. If this property satisfies, then only then the function will remain what? Will be a 1-1 function. So your f is not equal to g, but phi of f is equal to phi of g. So this means that this function phi is clearly not a 1-1 function.